On first down, they hand off to Marlon Mack. Huge hole, 50-yard line. He's at the 40, still going near sideline. He's at the 10. He's at the 5, and he will score. Touchdown, Marlon Mack. Touchdown, INDY. And again, it's picked off. It's Darius Leonard. Leonard with a second INT, and he's streaking down the near sideline. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. He's going to go. A pick six for the Maniac.
Horseshoe is back, baby. The horseshoe is back.
Hey, what's going on, Colts Nation? Welcome back to another episode of the Bring the Juice Colts podcast. The Indianapolis Colts made a move today, and they claim tight end Noah Togiai off of waivers from the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, Togiai was originally an undrafted free agent after the 2020 draft out of Oregon State. He's 6'4", 243 pounds. This move should not come as a surprise, especially considering the injury to Trey Burton. Who knows how long he's going to be out? We've anticipated from a couple weeks to maybe over a month. Who knows how long he's going to be out? And I was originally surprised that the Colts decided to only carry three tight ends initially when they cut down to 53. But now the Colts seem like they are adding a fourth tight end, adding more of a vertical threat. From what I've heard, he's a pretty good athlete. He's very athletic. He's the type of tight end that the Colts kind of need to complement Jack Doyle and Mo Alie Cox. But right now, as it seems, Togiai will be the number three tight end behind those two. So certainly a good move for depth purposes. I mean, overall, I feel like the Colts from 1 to 53 really have a good foundational roster. Tight end was one of those I was really not sure about how they were going to approach it. I felt like they were probably going to address it in some way in free agency. They do that. They claim Togiai off of waivers. Right now, that's the only move the Colts have made. The only guy they claimed off of waivers. There's still a lot of guys available. And maybe at the time you hear this, there might be some other guys who the Colts have signed. I feel like the Colts need to obviously address the cornerback position and potentially the backup offensive line position. They've already signed some guys that they initially cut to the practice squad, so we'll have a separate episode kind of addressing the practice squad a little bit more in depth and potentially what some of these players can provide on the practice squad. But right now, the only waiver claim the Colts make, Noah Togiai, a rookie this year out of Oregon State, very athletic type of player. Certainly hope the Colts can get stuff out of him. It seems like he had a really good year in training camp for the Philadelphia Eagles. I know there's a lot of Eagles fans that were upset that Togiai got claimed by the Colts. He was obviously sitting behind some good tight ends ahead of him, and he got cut at the final cuts, and the Eagles were hoping to potentially have him on their practice squad or the Colts scoop him up, get another addition, add some more depth to the tight end position. Certainly think it's a solid move for what they need to do on the offense, especially at the tight end position. Now it helps us feel a little bit better about what's going to happen with the tight end position moving forward. That'll do it for this episode, guys. Thanks so much. And as always, go Colts.